Notice that A is not common to all three terms. Therefore, A will not be part of the GCF. Notice that there's also, notice that there's not a GCF between 1, 1, and 6. Okay, there's not a number that will go into 1, 1, and 6. So we can go straight to factoring by doing product and sum. We need a product that comes from 1 times negative 6, which is negative 6. And the middle term is understood to be negative 1a, so we need a sum of negative 1. If it helps you, if it makes it easier for you, you can put a 1 here and a negative 1 here. That way you can see that the middle term is negative 1, and that's where our sum comes from. So if it helps you, you can do that. Okay. Now, we need two numbers that when we multiply them, we get a negative 6. But when we add those same two numbers, we get negative 1. Now, negative 3 times 2 gives us negative 6. And negative 3 plus 2 gives us negative 1. So negative 3 and positive 2 works out for us. It's the only pair that will work for us. So I'll bring down my n's of a squared and negative 6. And I'll fill in the middle with negative 3a and positive 2a. Now it's time to factor by grouping. The GCF is going to be the A with the smallest exponent. So I'll pull out A because it's common to both terms. And then to determine what goes inside the parentheses, I'll divide by the GCF A that I took out. A squared divided by A is A. These A's cancel and I'm left with minus 3. Here, A is not common to both terms, so it will not be part of the GCF. But there is a GCF between 2 and 6. 2 divided by 2 is 1. 6 divided by 2 is 3. And the GCF is 2. So, dividing each of these terms by 2, these 2's cancel, and I'm left with A. And negative 6 divided by positive 2 is negative 3. Notice that the factors are the same in each parenthesis, so when we write our answer, we have A plus 2 times A minus 3.